just shocked by how quick everything happened and escalated. You know, Tuesday, we're flying down with our team to Indianapolis for the Big Ten basketball tournament. Wednesday, we're in meetings with athletic directors, faculty athletic reps, at the Big Ten senior women administrators. Decision made not to allow fans after Wednesday night, and then you wake up, you know, after our game on Wednesday and find out that the tournament's going to be canceled. You know, I think people are just caught off guard by how quickly it escalated.
Can you take us kind of inside what it was like? I'm sure you had to deliver the news to coaches, to players about what was going on and what their reaction was when they heard this.
First off, I give President Gable a lot of credit because President Gable, you know, several weeks we started to have these conversations and started to prepare for things like this. And what was hard, Dave, was I was down in Indianapolis. We have a lot of our teams who are traveling across the country because it's spring break for campus. So we were able to do several conference calls with senior staff, with head coaches, trying to give them information. As we just talked about a second ago, this was real time, so you're trying to move quickly. And you know, I remember our baseball team was scheduled to go to Colorado for a series against the Air Force, and we're telling them not to take that flight, to hold off before any decisions were made, because we just felt like it was starting to go that direction.
This had to be tough for you, because there's a lot of kids that seniors and their careers are now over. Obviously, there's bigger problems in the world, but still for them at this point in their life, this is a pretty big issue.
Yeah, there's a lot of unknowns, you know, and you know, the other, I use the word disappointment. I don't know if that's the right word. I just feel so bad. So many of our student athletes, you know, the cool thing about what I do is I work around extremely competitive people, from the coaches to student athletes who want to compete at the highest level. And in a matter of hours, it all came to a screeching stop. Right? And we're trying to understand what that means. Imagine what those kids are trying to understand what it means.
What is next now? What are the next step for options for student athletes, and what's the timeline if you know one?
I think there's so much anxiety right now about what is this virus? What does it mean? How can it impact us? And so in terms of next steps, you know, we have daily conference calls with Big Ten leadership. Commissioner Warren, obviously we know him from the Viking days, has been unbelievable during this process. And so we keep having conversations with our peer institutions, with people on campus, and we'll figure out what the next steps are as we get more information. You know, these are difficult decisions, but they're made with the student athlete at the center of those decisions. And how can we keep the student athletes safe? How can we keep the coaches safe, the staff safe? How can we keep the media safe that covers us? And that's been our number one priority as we made these decisions for the past 3 or 4 days.